Hi, my name is Shubhrendu Gangopadhyay. I'm a hydrologic engineer at the Bureau of Reclamation's Technical Service Center in Denver. In this video, we'll step through the process of retrieving climate and hydrology projections data for your impacts analysis using the Downscale Climate and Hydrologic Projections website. This site is a result of collaboration between several federal and non-federal partners. In a previous video, I talked about necessary background information for using this site effectively. Now I'm going to give you a tour of the site and how to put together a data request. Before getting into any of the site's detail, please note the browser recommendations. Let's start with the Welcome tab. Here we have a summary, purpose, and history of the archive. Check here for which datasets are currently available. Here on the About tab, we provide information on archive development, drivers and motivation, scope of the archive contents, and projection attributes. We recommend you check this area periodically for information on updates and changes to the site. Here on the Climate subtab, we have a list of the attributes available for each downscaling approach. These include variables, time, and space. Note the different coverage and scope available for each of these approaches. The documentation and notes here provide some background on the currently available projections. On the Hydrology subtab, we have a description of the attributes and approaches used for developing hydrology projections from climate projections. Here, we describe the modeling scope and domain of the available downscale projections. Here, we outline the available attributes to be chosen for each downscaling approach. On the tutorial tab, we provide examples of how to use projection output from the site in actual analysis. These tutorials are organized by downscaling approach and provide examples of data retrieval and use of that data in impacts assessment. Next, we are moving into the substantive area of the projection site, the Projection Subset Request tab. This is the key area of the site you will use to get projection data. There are 10 steps for getting projection data. These must all be completed before submitting the request. The form status boxes help track these steps. As they are completed, each one will be highlighted. When you have completed the 10 steps, you will click the Submit Request button here. Here on the right, we have an indicator of the file size of the data request. Three factors determine the size of the data request. One, the number of variables selected. Two, the time period. And three, the spatial extent. If the size of the request exceeds 100%, then you will not be able to submit the request. On the Page 1 subtab, we will set the temporal and spatial extent. Here, we will complete steps 1 through 3, time step and period, domain and spatial extent. You can choose either climate or hydrology projections or a combination of the two. I'm going to show an example using the Upper Colorado River Basin. Now, for the first step, labeled 1.1, we look at time step and period. I'm going to choose the monthly time step for January 1950 through December 2099. For step 2, labeled 1.2, I'll choose the Colorado Basin for the domain. In step 3, for the spatial extent, I'm going to use the tributary area for the Upper Colorado River Basin defined by this latitude and longitude, which I'll paste here. This is the location of the Lees Ferry gauge. When I click Map Outlet Location, this area appears on the map. Clicking on the location marker shows me tributary information. Also note that there is help available for each step by clicking on the question mark button. Up here in the form status area, we now see that we have completed the first three steps. Note the next step is labeled 2.4, which indicates page 2, step 4. Moving along to page 2, we'll select our projection sets. Here we see that because we selected monthly time steps, only the monthly projections are available. Let's select the BCSD CMIP3 Hydrology Monthly Projection Set here in step 4. Now the corresponding sub-tab becomes available. On this tab, for step 5, we will select our variables. Let's select precipitation and total runoff. In step 6, we will choose projections. Note, a projection is a combination of emissions pathway or scenario, climate model, and a run with a given set of initial conditions. The emission scenarios are in the three main columns. Each row represents a climate model. For each climate model and each emissions path, there are one or more climate model runs represented by the check boxes. Boxes that are grayed out represent unavailable runs. The buttons along the top allow selecting or deselecting all projections from each emissions path. So now we see on our form status that we have completed steps 1 through 6. On page 3, starting with step 7, we are going to choose an analysis for the projection data or to simply extract the projection time series. We will choose statistics and spatial mean. Certain statistics may not be available depending on what variables you have selected. In step 8, we choose the output format for our results. NetCDF is useful for advanced users. We will choose ASCII text output. In step 9, we provide our email address to receive a notification and link to download the requested data. Finally, in step 10, we ask that you provide some information on how you will make use of the data requested. This helps us track how well we are serving the needs of our various communities. Before submitting, check the form status to see if you have chosen all required variables. You can return to each step by clicking on the form status boxes. We recommend taking a moment to verify your selections before submitting your request. When you click Submit, you will see a summary and another Submit button to click after verifying your choices. The request is not submitted until you click the second Submit button. After submission, a message will appear with an estimated time for completion. Looking up at the top level tabs, the Projections Complete Archives tab provides FTP access to download any of the projection-specific full coverage datasets available for you to work with directly. Archives are posted in NetCDF format. Accessing the data archives in this way is recommended for advanced users only. Use the form on the Feedback tab to send us any questions or comments. Check the FAQ first to see if an answer to your question has already been posted. The Links tab provides additional resources and background information. The climate and hydrology model resources on this site will be updated, so be sure to check back periodically. Thanks for watching.